Rising tide lifts all boats, but a lot of people don't have boats, and this trickle down effect doesn't quite work, you know. But we get that from a lot of politicians that, this trickle. We have to make our millions first, and then you'll get your slice of the pie, or whatever. But that doesn't seem to happen. Whereas we kind of work from the ground up, and we say, well, you know, a rising tide doesn't lift all boats, you know, and that's where we feel that. You know, being involved in community TV, it's just one way of exploring ways of bringing about access to health, education, and housing in a kind of more equal way.
Yeah, I mean, we are just working on a project there at the moment with a group of traveller women from the Cork Traveller Women's Network, and this would be an ethnic minority grouping here in Ireland. There would be somewhere around 25,000 travellers in Ireland, and for a lot of people there's still a huge amount of discrimination when it comes to housing and health, education. Very, very few travellers would go on to third level education. Many travellers have literacy issues. Up until recently they were actually segregated in schools, which a lot of people don't know. They actually had to be kept apart from the other children. And now that's changed, but still traveller children face a lot of isolation because they're very much stigmatised. And you know, a lot of the other children just don't want to mix with them. And this is because of the way they have been portrayed in the mainstream media over the years. Travellers have a reputation for being violent and for causing fights, and if there's ever any media about or coverage, it's usually following some kind of a fight or something. Whereas if you go downtown into Cork City on a Saturday night, there's plenty of fights from what the travellers would call the settled community ourselves, and it doesn't get the same level of reporting or the same size of the headlines. So, you know, this group will now want to make a DVD about their culture and trying to make people understand more about who they are, and they're facing a lot of change. They are a nomadic group, and their ways of travelling around the country and going from town to town is being threatened. They're being forced out of caravans and trailers into houses, and even though some of them will accept this and improve better facilities, they still want to be able to maintain their culture. So those kind of groups, I think the importance for them to be able to access the media and challenge some of those stereotypes that still persist, that's the kind of thing that's hugely important. But there's a lot of inequality still there. Certainly the Celtic Tiger, as Eddie was saying,
But in saying that, where it's not all negative programs. I think there are so many brilliant projects, from music projects to arts projects, and that are happening in the communities that don't get covered, you know, and some festivals, and there are intercultural events happening, and parades and things like that going on, and very positive things, and they come about because there's an awful lot of work being done in the community by arts groups who work with communities and bringing about, you know, whether it's a music piece or an arts piece and stuff like that. Sometimes they don't get covered in the mainstream media because, you know, they're happening in communities that, you know, the mainstream media don't feel they're interested in. You know, they don't cover it, you know.